Hi everyone, good morning, good evening. Today we have a topic related to static code analysis. That means in this topic we will see how we can leverage PMD static code analyzer and the command line interface to analyze your Apex code. So when I say analyzing your Apex code, it's kind of doing a code review automatically so that you can get to know whether your code is up to standard, whether it is following the best practices or not, and is it also in the security standard what is applicable for the Apex code. Okay, first thing here, if you can see, the step one will download the PMD from the pmd.github.io website, which is a openly available GitHub page where you can go and download the zip version of the PMD. Then the second thing what we'll do is we'll extract that PMD from the zip folder and put it somewhere in our directory and set up the PMD CLI path so that we can execute the PMD command through the CLI. Then the step three, we'll try to generate a report. That means the code analysis report in a CSV format. First, we'll try to check the quick start. Quick start in the sense it will just go through the code and find out what are all those fix we are supposed to do or what are the problem in our code. So there are different types of rule set available in PMD. First, we'll try to execute the quick start, which is the simplest one. Then we can go into granular level like security and all those things. In the step four, we'll try to find out how we can go into deep granular level and try to execute a security related command, let's say Apex CRUD violation. CRUD means create, read, update, delete, right? Is there any violation we are doing in our code, right? And at the last, I will try to show you how you can determine which one is priority for you. When you are doing a code review, you may get a setup suggestion, violation in your code, but you have to prioritize those and fix those things so that your code can go through the appropriate process. There is a Visual Studio plugins available for PMD, but in this demonstration we are not going to do it through Visual Studio code. We are going to do it through the PMD command line interface. Okay, step number one, first we'll try to go to this pmd.github.io and download the PMD GitHub zip folder so that we can configure it in our local system and execute the command. So to do that, you have to go to pmd.github.io and then there is a download option here. You have to click on this download option. So what it will do is it will download the zip file. I have already downloaded. I will stop this download process right away, but once your download is complete, you just extract that download and keep it into a directory folder so that you can leverage it. So for me, I already kept it in my D drive. So I extracted the PMD folder from the zip and I kept it over here. So what I have to do is I have to go up to the bin folder. Okay, so once you are in the bin folder, you will see the list of batch files are over here. So you have to go up to that point, then copy the URL from the directory structure. If you are using Windows machine, you can use the quick search and find out environment variable. Okay, so when you click environment variable, there are two options you will see in Windows. One is environment variable for your account. Another is edit the environment variable. I would prefer to go with this one because if you are using corporate laptop or all those things, maybe this one is blocked for you because of the administrative privilege and all. So ideally I would prefer to go with this one, edit environment variable for your account. Just click on that. Okay, now once you are there, you will find an option called path. Okay, click on that path, then click edit. Now once you are in the screen, just click new and add the path, the bin path of your PMD. Okay, that's all. Now you click OK, then click OK, done. You have set up the PMD commands now. That means step number one and step number two we have created, because we have downloaded the PMD github.io unzipped it, put it into a directory structure. Second thing, we have created the environment path setting for the PMD CLI. Okay, then the third thing what we'll do is we'll just run a quick start. That means to do that, what you have to do is first extract your project folder. Okay, that means if you are using the Selfos DX, you can create a DX folder. If you are using GitLab or GitHub, you can run on that GitLab and GitHub folder as well. Okay, wherever your source code is available, that means the Apex source code is available, you have to go there in your folder structure. For me, I have created a project, and in this project I have my Apex class available in the classes folder. Okay, here in the classes folder, my all those list of Apex classes, whatever I have, it is available. Okay, so what I wanted to do is I wanted to run, okay, my command on these classes and try to see which one is having any problem and all those things, right? So to do that, what you can do quickly in Windows, just in the same folder, clear the directory path, write cmd. Okay, now you are, if you can see, you are at the path force-app pen default classes where my source code is available. So there are different kinds of rule sets in PMD. That means there is a high level rule sets available in the quick start. First we will see that, then after we'll go into deeper granular level security and all those things. I'll demonstrate that in later stages. So what we'll do is we'll copy this path. First thing you remember here, we are using a CSV format here. You can also use HTML or text format over here, but for me ideally the CSV is a good one so that I can export it to Excel file and all those things. That's why I have used CSV, but you can use text, that means plain text or HTML. There are other formats also available, but I am going with CSV. Here the dot notation, if you see, this dot notation is representing your current folder. Okay, that means the class folder where we are standing right away. Okay, and which rule sets we are executing. In this situation we are executing quick start. Quick start means we are not going into deeper granular level. We wanted to do a high level code analysis. Okay, then after we'll go into deeper granular level. So now copy this command, because just to save our time I have already created those command, and paste it over here and run. It will take some time. Okay, it is running now, if you can see. Okay, what it is doing is basically it is reading all your class from the folder and analyzing, is there anything missing in your classes you are supposed to do but you have not done, or any code violation or any security violation. All those things it is checking. It may take some time. Here one trick I will tell you. From the command line there is no straight away option to export it to a CSV, but if you know some writing some script and all those things, you can do that. But for me, what I'll do is I'll simply select Ctrl A. I'll select all those things. Then I'll do one thing. I'll copy this. Okay. Then what I'll do is I'll click on Notepad plus plus. Okay, in my Notepad plus plus, what I'll do is I'll paste all those things, whatever I copied, right? While you copy, two things you have to do. Once you copy, what you can do is you can remove this first line. This is not required for you. Okay, and also remove the last line. here after these things, right? Remove this last line. Okay, now we have removed the first line and the last line. What we'll do is we will click on save as. Okay, and what I'll do, I'll go to desktop, and there is a report folder over here. Here I'll say quick start, okay, .csv, and change the normal file to all file so that it will not override your extension. Then click on save. Okay, now this is saved, but here it is very difficult to read this file. What you can do is you can go to that report folder, okay, and open that in Excel. Okay, now you can see over here your things are coming. So you can see maybe this first line, all those things are not applicable for you, you can remove. You see here in metadata service, okay, there are some problems. The instance field name, packaging, version type, importer does not match this criteria. It should be A to Z and 0 to 9, but it is not matching. Okay. Similarly, you see here Apex documentation. That means at the top of the class, we used to write some documentation. Who is the author of this class? Who is when this class got created? When this class got modified, what is the test class for that class, right? All those documentations are missing. Similarly, you can see there are some schema problem as well as some object name type does not matching the appropriate, you know, criteria. All these things are there. So if you'll go through all those things, you can better understand what is this and all those things. So for one particular classes, you see all those list of problems are there. Similarly, you have to run through all the list of classes. For example, here is a class, right? In this class, Apex documentation comment is missing, right? So there are some classes where cyclomatic complexity problem is there. Cyclomatic complexity problem means if you can check on that, you know, that means it is going into deeper level, right? So that is called cyclomatic complexity. Your if else condition or the multiple if conditions, nested if condition, those are some things which used to create the cyclomatic complexity, right? So based on that, you can find out and you can ask your developer to correct those code. So this is one thing what I saw in a high level, that how you can quickly understand the problem in your list of classes. So we have seen that how we can do the quick start, but if you wanted to go to granular level and wanted to find out more specific things, like how this CRUD, is there any CRUD violation, is there any security violation, how we can check that, there is a URL over here. If you will go and check that over here, so you will see that, you know, in PMD there are so many other rules are there, not only the quick start. There are rules related to Apex CRUD violation, there are rules related to Apex bad crypto, there are rules related to open redirect URL, sharing violation, SQL injection, all those things. Let's say you wanted to see SQL injection, you have to click on that. You can see that, you know, how to use that SQL injection. And this is where the thing, priority. Okay, if you are violating a SQL injection, whether it is a high priority, whether it is a medium priority, whether it is a low priority, right? So this SQL injection is coming out on medium priority. Means anything you are doing in the SQL injection analysis, these are coming on medium priority, right? Okay. So any specific rule set you wanted to execute and go into more detail level, so you have to copy that rule set name from here. And what you have to do is you have to replace this quick start with the appropriate rule set you wanted to execute. In this scenario, what I'm going to execute is Apex CRUD violation. If you'll see after these things, right, category Apex security.xml, then Apex CRUD violation, right? This is what I'm going to execute. Now copy this thing and go to your command line, click CLS, clear the screen, then run the command again. Okay, this time you will not get all the things which is violating, but you will see only the things which are violating based on the CRUD. That means the create, read, update and delete, those DML operations, right? So now you see that, you know, all these things are now created. What I'll do is I'll simply say Control A, select all, copy, okay, bring it to here in any text editor. Then, as I was saying that, you know, you have to remove unnecessary things, right? So for example, up to this thing I don't need really, okay? So remove. Then you can also remove the last few things so that it will be clean, okay? Now what you do is you just save it, save as, okay, in the report I'll say CRUD. This is something related to CRUD. Then I'll change this to all file and save it. Okay, now it will go to that folder again, report folder. It will go to the report folder again. You see one more file, click on that, and this time you see only CRUD violation things are coming, which are under the security rule set. Okay, so anything CRUD violation happens at what line number and all those things, there is some certain classes over here and their line number is given. At what line number the class name is given, the line number is given, and what is the CRUD violation happened. Validate CRUD permission. That means when you are doing some SQL or DML operation, maybe you are not checking whether the record is readable, record is editable, whether the field is readable or the field is editable. If you are not doing, then these are the violations your PMD code analysis will give you, so that you can direct or you can guide your development team that these are the things we have to fix before going on a production live. I think you would have enjoyed my session today. You would have learned something from my session. If you like my video, please subscribe to my channel, do a thumbs up, provide some suggestion in comment box so that I'll try to incorporate and improve in my next session. Thanks again. See you next time.